Hello and welcome to Sparetime Amusements in Whitensville, Massachusetts, where we have our 85% handicap King of the Hill matchup. Today's qualifiers are Mike Nardone, Joe Duda will be met in the first string, battling it out with eight pins going for four pins for Joe.
Mike is getting four.
Followed by that, we have Anthony Caron in the number two spot. Our number one qualifier was Dave Peterson, and the winner of last month's King of the Hill was John Dorian. The next ball is live, and so like we said, four pins for Mr. Nardone, bowling on lane nine as we start. Bowling first on lane 10 will be Joe Duda. Fireballer, just off on the six pin, but he gets six to fall. Nardone is just left, and he bites off five, has the head pin, the 7-8, and the 6-10. Duda continues to be wide right. Third ball coming up, and that's an 8 for Duda. And 9 for Nardone, so Nardone's advantage. Now 5 pins for Mr. Nardone on lane 9. Joe Duda bowls out of Masons, I believe, and out west in French King. Again, right of the head pin, takes out everything but the head pin. He'll have a good look at a spare. Nardone knocks down 8. He's got the 4-8 pin left. A little bit of defending wood. Duda with a spare. Nardone clears his spare. So they're a pair of spares in the second for our handicapped competitors. Nardone has a 5-pin lead. 4 of those were from the handicap. And Duda, right of the head pin again. He's got 6 in his fill. Nardone, light hit. On the 1-2 pocket, he's got 6. So, no blood there. Still a 5-pin difference. And Duda will be open in the third. Third ball's coming up. Today's action brought to you by Yali. I'm filling in for Eric Bromberg. Para 8's there, no blood. Lead continues to be 5 pins for Nardone, 4 of those from the handicap. First ball in the fourth. Duda's right in the pocket, and he loses the 7-pin. He's got the 10-pin. Nardone is off on the 4-pin. Neither bowler was in the bonus. Duda will be open in the fourth, as will be Nardone. That's a 10. Duda now at 42. Nardone looking at 2 with his third ball. He's got him. So no blood in the fourth. He's at 47, Duda at 42. The bowlers will change after this box. Nardone with a 5-pin lead. Here comes Duda. This time he's left, but he's got an eagle wing. Left with a 1. Oh, 9 drop for Nardone. Is the 1-3-6. This one's a 57%er for a pro. There it goes. Second mark for Duda. Nardone follows suit, making good on his 6-pin. They switch sides. Both players with a spare in the fifth. Both players at fifth. Well, Duda at 52 in a ball. Nardone at 57 in a ball. There's only been 1-pin change. We start with a 4-pin advantage based on handicap. Nardone has the 5-pin lead. He's in the pocket and drops all 10. Strike on spare. Duda's in the pocket, but he only grabs 5. He's got the hay bale on the left. 8-pin sleeper in the back. He's got it. He's got it. Both bowlers mark in the fifth. Nardone with the strike. Duda with the 5, but he's got a 10-pin lead right now. His first half, 67 to Duda's 57. 4 of that was handicapped. Nardone now working on 2 bonus balls. His first left of the pocket, he gets 4. Duda right in the pocket again, but he's rewarded with a 5, 4, 5, 7. Has a little bit of wood to help, but not facing the right direction. Nardone with a nice bid. I think he's looking at the 5 pin still for his third ball. Both bowlers open in the seventh. That'll be a 9. And an 8. So score is now 95-82. Nardone was in the double bonus there. He ended up with 9 bonus pins to Duda's 7. So it's a 13-pin lead, and there are 3 to play. Nardone continues to pound the head pin. He's got the 5. And Duda is just right. He knocked out 3. He's got the 4 horses and the 8-pin left and the 2-pinner on the right, consisting of the 6-10. Nardone could put this away right here, but he's left. He's left. He's left the door open just a little bit. Both bowlers open in the 8th. Nardone at 104 through 8. And Duda with 8 goes to 90. So that's a 14-pin lead. 10 of those from the bowling, 4 of those from the handicap. 2 to play. Duda's looking at the need for 2 marks right now to be sure. Nardone shaking on the 6-pin, but it's standing. Good follow, but 3-1 leave from Duda. It was right in the 1-3 pocket. That one is touching. He does have a chance. For all practical purposes, Nardone just needs this. Put Duda into triple strike territory. That's it. So Duda now needs to make this mark. All right, so that's 114 and a ball through 9 for Nardone. And talking at 98, so we're talking about a 16-pin difference here. Still reachable with a triple strike, with a double strike plus a big fill. But Duda has his work cut out for him. And with 9 dropped there, I believe. Let's give him a chance, but I think that should do it. Nice bowling from Nardone. He's already at 123. He's got a 9 drop to the 5 pin with his 10th. Spare there. That's 133 and a ball. Duda not going out without some noise. He's at 108, but his day will be over. He'll come in 4th place today. He qualified 4th, just a few pins ahead of yours truly, Bob Lee. Right around his average. Pins are moving slowly today. Another 9 drop for Nardone. That was a 142. That is the day's high score so far, is it not, Justin?
That is correct.
So Mike Nardone advances. He'll be facing Anthony Karen.
Again?
And Mr. Karen will choose which lane to stand on. He's got a 99 average. What are you playing with?
I'm coming in over 105.
So are we talking about is that a 6-pin difference or a 5, Justin?
Yeah, 5 pins.
5. So 5 pins for Mr. Karen this time. Anthony had knee surgery on July 2nd. was telling me earlier today that his average was 97 before the surgery and has been up around 102 since the surgery. And he certainly was bowling like that today. He started with a 109, and that helped him qualify. He dropped back toward his average for the remainder of the day, but this ball is live. Mr. Karen, you're ready for live bowling, right?
I'm waiting for Justin.
Okay.
Let me get the board ready.
Yep. So we're clearing up the board. And if he's on... If there's another guy who wants to warm up, I was just saying they should warm up on another lane if we're going to do that. Anyway, if you just joined us, we're in the second round. Spare time of Whitensville handicap, 85%. Later today, we'll do the scratch. Anthony Karen, live bowling here on lane 10. Just on the edge. Let's see if we can bring him into play. He's off on the six pin. Drops a couple. Nardone, who just put up a 142, drops seven. He's now looking at the 245. A little piece of wood behind. Karen will be open. Nardone's got it. Without any wood, that one is a 45%. We just checked our data on that over the last week. Karen with a beautiful 10. So Anthony starts today leading by five. Nardone has already made a mark. The score is now 10-10, but Nardone is in the bonus. Second box coming up. Karen, if you're used to watching Anthony, whether you watch him at Mason's or Lita Lane's, nine drop for Nardone. So he's already got a four-pin lead. He's taking care of the bonus. He's at 19 through. And he has a four-pin lead in the match. Nice! Drop of the box. Anyway, I was going to say that the triangle is a 45%. The box is a 45%. And that's what Anthony just cleared on. Not easy to get the front and back to fall with both side pins. Nardone is two spares in a row to start. And nine in his fill so far. So he's at 29 through two. Karen at 20 and a ball. Both players in the bonus, starting the third string right here. Karen drops seven off the head pin. He's got the 1-2-4. Nardone, he's got all 10. See him swinging around. That's three marks in a row. And it's already at 49 through three. Karen is open. He drops nine in the third. He's at 41. So it's an eight-pin lead plus this ball for Nardone, who just put up a 142 moments ago. Yet picking out our number four seed, Joe Duda. Dave Peterson from Norwood is going to meet the winner. Karen is not giving up yet. He drops nine to the nine pin and has a guide. Nardone stays in the pocket, drops nine more. He's got duck soup in front right now, but looks like that leading pin is falling away. All he has to do is hit that. Karen probably had that one if he was on the low side of that piece of wood. Nardone, four marks in a row to start. He's already at 69 pins. I think we'll be seeing him later in the scratch competition. So, through four, score is now 69 to 50. Nardone also in the bonus. He's got four marks in a row. And Karen punches through the three hole. Nardone finally misses a head pin. He's got the 1-3-7-8. Another six, though, for... He's at 75. And it looks like he'll be... Well, everyone thinks it comes back. Shakes the head pin, but it won't fall. He never touched it with his ball. So after three spares and a strike, Nardone is open in the fifth, and he'll be changing sides with a score of 84. Anthony Karen with a 58, and there's our score. You can go back further. There you go, Justin. Drop it down, and you can see their names even more. There you go. That's what we can see. 84 to 58. Thank you. Here's Mike Nardone to start the sixth. Left of the head pin, he's got the four horses and a sleeper in the back. That's the nine pin. Karen follows suit, but he's got a little more to work with. He's got the seven, the eight, and the nine. Nardone's thin on the head pin and will be open in the sixth. Nice ball from Karen, but the king pin won't budge. That'll be a nine for Nardone in the sixth. He's at 95. And Karen takes one more, one out of that. He's at 68. Sorry, that's 93 for Nardone. Looks like it is at 25 pins. Okay, Nardone finds the three hole and he picks out three. Karen drops three from the left side. The triangle on the left is gone. Both, well, sorry. Nardone will be open in seventh. And Karen is flush on the head pin. Takes only the one and five. That's a six. Karen. That'll help. That'll help. So that's two more. That'll knock it down to 23 with three to play. Score is 99-76. Nardone started with four marks to start this one. If you just joined us, we're in the second round of the ladder. Nardone off the head pin, but leaves the 1-7-9. Karen flush in the 1-3 pocket, but he's got the triangle in the corner. 6-9-10. All right. So after nothing seemed to stop, Nardone started with a 142 and four marks to start this one. Karen has his mark. He's not done yet. Nardone playing defense gets the 10. He's at 109 through 8. Karen at 86 and the next ball. Trying to cut into that 23-pin lead. Which is two more to play, and there you go. Nardone with the strike just made this one really hard to reach. Karen, now I think he's going to need two or three strikes at this point. And a good mix. That's a four. That's a four. So temporarily knocks the lead back to 19. But he'll be open in the ninth. Nardone with the strike and the 19-pin lead. And make it a 20-pin lead. So he's got a strike, he's got a ball, and 19 pins. It's almost out of reach. Karen is in triple strike territory. And Nardone still can take things into his own hand with a good fill here on his strike. This is the first ball of the 10th. On the head pin, 8 drop. That should do it. Nardone will advance. Nice bid by Anthony. He's in triple digits. But there's nothing he can do to beat the 6 marks from Mike Nardone in this one. So after his 142, he's coming back with a... .139 and a ball to finish things up. So he's... All right, so three or better to beat his 142? All right, so here he is, 139 and a ball. This is the last ball of the second round. Yeah. for Mike Nardone. He's in the head point again. 9. And another 9 drop. That's a 150. No, 148. 148.
Hey, one more pitch, Charlie.
Here's our tournament director, Justin Scally. That's perfect. You put your head in there. Nice job. So you see, second round, Mike Nardone advances. He'll be up against our number one seed, Dave Peterson.
Welcome to the
what was Dave's qualifying score? Dave's qualifying score, if we have that.
I'm good to go.
All right, Dave's going to take a warm-up. So he's giving you time to race. These are not live balls. Dave Peterson is warming up. And you'll see he's taking a little break. And he's going to need a couple seconds to warm up. He just joined us. This is round 3 of the handicap special.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a scratch match in the next round.
Oh, both 105s?
Both 105s.
All right.
How many pins are we getting?
It's zero. Scratch match. And it's going to be for 20 boxes, right?
This
is the semifinal. We're in the semifinal, so it's only 10 boxes. All right, John Dorian is waiting in the wings. What did John score last time to take the king?
I don't know.
So we'll see. John's warming up on lane 5 in the far distance.
We are down to the final 3, so we are in the money. Loser.
Dave, are you ready?
Ready?
Do you know which lane you're going to choose?
Ready to go.
Okay. All right, Mr. Nardone is coming in from the from Church Street. Coming off scores of 142 and 148. I think he got 4 pins in the 142, though, didn't he? So it was actually a 138 and a 1. Mike Nardone's next ball is live, and we are starting the semifinal match here. Right on the head pin, 8 drop, 2. The 4-8 and guarding wood. Dave Peterson is just right of the head pin. He's looking at the 4 horses and the post. Nardone begins where he left off with a spare to start the semifinals. Great bid by Peterson. Peterson, who bowls out of Norwood, had a 99-100 average the last 2 seasons. But his local average here at Sparetime is 105. So today's match is a scratch match. Mike Nardone comes out of the first box with a bonus ball and a 2-pin lead, though. Having posted a spare to best Peterson's 8. Well, right at the head pin, he gets 3, so that's a 13. 5-pin lead to start today. Peterson, somewhat thin strike, but he's got the eagle wing left. 247. Nardone, right in the 1-2 pocket, but the kingpin won't fall. On the bundle at 7. Peterson needs a skip. He gets it off the sidewall from the wood. The head pin had fallen in front of the 2-pin and came to help him out later. So Nardone will take a 9. His lead drops down to 4 pins. 22 to 18. Dave Peterson is in the bonus, looking at if he can get 4 pins or more, he'll take to be a lead change. First ball, the 3rd box for Nardone. He's on the head pin and drops 9. That's the 2-pin. A little bit of wood to help. Peterson takes out the mini rack and has the 4 horses. He now has a 2-pin lead. And that's the 2nd spare for Nardone in the 3rd. And that's wide, right? And it looks like we're going to see another lead change in a moment. Great semifinal action here at Sparetime in Whitensville. Peterson takes 2. Played it safely on the 2-pin, but still takes an 8. He's at 32 with 1 mark through 3. Nardone is at 32 plus this ball. 9 drop for Nardone to the 4 pin. And Peterson is looking at the 127. The 7 is shaking but won't fall. So those 9 bonus pins. And that little piece of wood helps him out. He wipes the brow, thanking the wood for that. And Peterson will be open in the 4th. 3 marks in the first 4 boxes for Nardone. He's at 51 plus a ball after 4. Peterson drops 9 more. He's at 41. So it's a 10-pin lead plus a bonus ball. Mike Nardone was 3 out of 4 before that, and he's off the head pin, but no harm done. He's got the 1-3 remaining and 8 in the bonus. So
magic is there.
After following up on scores of 138 and 148, he's already he makes that spare. That's 69 and a ball as Peterson took out the threesome, the little 259, you know, that comes from the right to left ball occasionally when you just miss. This is his 3rd ball coming up. He's going for the trip. Ball in the corner, but he'll settle for a 7. That's a 48 average. 48 half. So we're going to pause for the halftime score. You see, there it is. 69 in the ball for Mike Nardone. Dave Peterson with a 48. And we're bowling scratch. This is the semifinal. The winner gets to face John Dorian in a 20-box match. Just a few minutes. Dorian warming up on 5. Tearing out the pocket. Here's Peterson. Right of the head pin. He's got a 5-1. Nardone drops 7. Those were bonus pins, though, so that's a 76 half for Nardone, who comes into this one with scores of 138 and 148 scratch. This is his 3rd match, trying to get to the finals. High-low jack won't go for Peterson. And Nardone open in the 6th with a 9. That's 85. He has 4 spares. Peterson is at 55, 30 behind with 1 spare. Nardone's been doing his league bowling this summer. Out in Millis. His average has been hanging around 108 to 111. Peterson had the half Worcester. Takes out the 2 instead of the 6. He'll be looking at an open frame. Nardone with his 5th spare at 95 and a ball through 7. And we're playing a 10-string match here. And that was for a 9 for Peterson. He's at 64. I think we're at Nardone's at 196 through his 1st 2. And right now he's already 15 over in another ball, so I think he's looking at a 400 game if he keeps going like this. Oh, tough 3-pin fill there. That's his 2nd 3 fill from the 5 spares he has this game. He's at 98, 28 over. Came in 86 over, so he's already well into the 400s for the last 3 matches we've been showing you. This is ball number 3, however. Dave Peterson with the spare. He's not giving up. That's a 7. 105 through 7. Peterson at 65 in a ball, trailing by 41 with two to go. And this is the bonus. That's a 2-4 variant on the half Worcester. Nardone is left of the head pin as a 1-3-7. Oh, what a shot from Nardone for his sixth spare here in the third match. Well, we've been showing that he's had a 138, a 148, and he is now sitting at 115 and a ball through 9. That's 25 over with a bonus ball coming. So that means if he gets all 10s from now on, he'd have, well, he'll have 125 plus whatever he has on this ball, which is just left. That's a 2. All right, so he's now 27 over. He's got the half Worcester left. He went down route 28. Peterson picks out 3. Still got the head pin. 7 dropped through the second ball for Nardone. We're in the 9th frame here. That'll be a 7. And that, my friends, is a 124 scratch, which is, yeah, 398? No, 3408. I believe, unofficially.
38, 48, and
410. It's a 4. So here we go. So let's show us. So yes, now we have a verified. That was a 410 from Mike Nardone, and he'll be in the final in just about 2 minutes with John Dorian. And there you can see it. Move it just a little right. There you go. 124. So scores of 138, 142, and 124 for Mike Nardone here in the 85% handicap. You will be in the scratch later, correct?
Did you tell him how much I threw in the qualifier?
Yeah, stand over here. How did you do in the qualifier, Mike?
My highest string was a 102.
Okay.
I'm saving it for now.
Very well done. You see, Dave Peterson's picking up his balls. He'll be driving Bob Lee, yours truly, home in a second. You can wait for me. You want to enter the scratch? Feel free. You had a nice set. There's no reason not to play again. All right. So John Dorian. Hey John. John, are you warm? And are you choosing lane 10 or are you choosing lane 9?
This is two strings.
This is two strings. And John, do you remember what your qualifying score was? What your winning score was last time?
Eric heard you when he sent it to me.
Okay.
It's right there.
All right. So John had a 380 last week, 332 scratch last month to qualify. So you got your work cut out for you, Mike, with your 410. Our tournament director is just calculating right now what the deficit will be, and this is over two strings.
I got to get you money. Yeah. Okay. So I'll give it to you at the end. One pin? Hold on.
We think it's going to be one.
Yeah. I mean, 85% of two is one.
It's actually, it might be two, though.
Guys, scratch match. You're 105.
Oh, there we go. Beautiful. That's another scratch match. Both of them coming in with local averages of 105.
You would have been giving me two. You did give me two.
All right. So may the best man win. Next ball will be live, and it'll be coming from John Dorian on lane 10.
Nardone attempting to run the ladder.
Just right of the head pin, he's got the four horses. Nardone in, leaves the check mark, fronted by the three pin. He's got the 3, 5, 6, and 10. Check marks. We'll go, and that one does. Use a little bit of wood. He's back on the marks.
That's why I didn't erase the first box yet.
And that'll be an 8 to start. Scratch match today. We're going 20 boxes. This is your final. The July King of the Hill, John Dorian, will be throwing his first ball in the second string in just a moment on lane 10. For the moment, he is down 8 pins, plus this ball. Make it 16, an 8 drop to the 3-6 for Nardone. Great bid by Dorian. But Nardone is leaving no doubt. Two spares to start for Nardone, who just posted a 4-10 triple a moment ago to qualify from the number 4 slot. Dorian with a 9, he's at 17. Nardone at 28 and a ball, already leading by 11. We're playing 20. Lemon drop. And a clipped eagle for Nardone. He gets 5 in the bonus. He's at 33. So with a 16-pin lead, second ball's coming up in the third. No harm. 5 pins in front of both bowlers. Third ball coming up. That'll be an 8 for John. And an 8 for Nardone. 41, 25, 16 pin lead. Nardone started the action with 2 straight spares. Dorian with 2 8s and a 9 so far. This is the first ball in the fourth. Right in the 1-3 pocket, he drops 8. Nardone finds 8, but he's got the 1-8 left, and the wood is pointed away, so he's gonna have to get it naturally. Might be aiming for the right side of the 1. A little too far, right? Dorian, open, but with a 10. Picks up 1. He's at 35. Nardone at 50 through 4. Bowlers will be changing places after this next box. Difference is 15. Good miss. Dorian has just the kind of let's throw a half Worcester. He needs to use the 1-8-9 wide right. Nardone has 3 and a sleeper, so that's the 9 pin in the back, eagle wing on the right. Orange pin back there is going to help, but not if you miss that. Good out for a 9. 44 half for Dorian. He had 2 8s, 2 9s, and a 10. Nardone waiting for the wood to come to rest. Back behind the head pin. He's already at 50. This will be his third ball in the fifth. You can see that's the kind of precision he's been showing here. He put a 4-10 in his first 3 strings. That was a 60 half, which is relatively weak for Nardone, but he has a 16-pin lead. Remember, we're playing 20. This is the finals. You see our substitute tournament director, Justin Scally, showing the scores. First ball in the sixth from Nardone. Drops 7 to the 2-1. He's got the Nardone looking at the 4-7-10. Wooded. He's got a chance, but a little late. 1-2-4 for Dorian. It's a little right. Nothing falls. That'll be a 9. 69 through 6. And a pair of nines there. That was a 53 for Dorian. Through six and a 69. So the lead is 16. Nardone has the two marks, the only two marks in this match so far. Dorian takes them all. That five pin was the last to fall. That's his first mark. And just in time to start the seventh, Nardone is wide left. He still has one left. He's waiting for a ball to come back. One just dropped down. There are a couple. Tough eight for Nardone. We got a match now. It's 77 to 63. Dorian in the bonus with two balls. Nine, 10 drop. The nine was the last to fall for Nardone, and he matches the strike that he we just saw a moment ago. All right, good fill off the head pin from John Dorian. He's still got the seven pin, but he's got the one and three in the front. Nardone made this one a moment ago in the semifinal. What a shot! What a shot! Spare on strike for Dorian. That hit puts him at 83. Nardone, who just dropped a strike, is at 87. So he's nominally a four-pin lead plus a ball for Nardone. He drops four. He's got the four and two on his first. He's got another bonus coming. Dorian just dropping, just moving one step now. Standing well behind the line. Takes six in the bonus. He's at 89. Through eight. Remember, we're playing 20, and it's going. It's rolling behind. Scratch the back of the calf of the four pin, I think. And Dorian's in the pocket. Wipes out the three of the four horses. I believe that is Famine remaining in the spot of the six pin. Nardone with a nine. Dorian's found his space now. He's got 10. That's 99 through nine for Dorian. 105 for Nardone, a six pin lead. We're playing 20 boxes. Remember this is the first ball in the 10th. Spare time, 85% handicap special. Nine drop, but it's the two and one, the 5, 6, 7, 5, 6, 10, sorry. Look at everything falling from behind. It could go. Everything but the head pin falls for Dorian, who obviously missed the head pin a little left. Nardone slips and shoots that one left. He had a look at it. He had a look at the five pin. Dorian, wide right. Jake Strong t-shirt. Nardone open with an eight. And Dorian with a nine. So he picks up one more. The lead is down to five. The first half score we're going to see in a moment from tournament director Justin Scaley. Mike is Mike Nardone. John is John Dorian. It was a 113 to 108 half. And we're going into the second half. Scratch match. This is an 85% handicap, but both bowlers coming in with local handicaps of 105. John Dorian will be throwing the first ball in the 11th string on lane 10 next. Just right of the head pin. Knocks out three. Nardone drops six to the check mark left, and he's got the head pin kind of half interfering. Let's see. He's going to cover it. He's going. Can't take out the three pin or the 10. Both bowlers open. That'll be a nine in the 11th. Good 10. Lead goes to 6 now. You saw just a moment ago, Mike Nardone put up 113 to John Dorian's 108. What we just saw there was a 10 for Nardone and a 9 for Dorian. That gives us a lead of 6 pins overall. Oof. That was the 159. Spread Eagle plus the Talon, plus the 8-pin Talon. Whitensville's finest going by behind us. Good bid from Dorian. He'll be open. Bundle of 5 here. Can't get the 4-7 to shake. Third ball is coming up in the 12th. Dorian will take a 7. He's at 16, following on a 108. Nice 10 there from Nardone. He's at 20 through 2. Lead is now 9. Thank you, Dave. There are 8 to play. Nardone put up scores 138, 148, and 124 before putting up his 113 in the first half here. Dorian's on the head pin, but he clips himself a spread eagle, minus the 7 pin. Good job wiping out the wing left. 4 horses and a post for Nardone. This one doesn't fall, though. That one is going at a 20% rate for pros, so don't be surprised. And that's an 8 on the clipped eagle for Dorian. Waiting for the pin to come to a rest. It looks like it's pointed in the right direction. His choice now to go around it. He's going around it. He got it. Right down the rail, and he picks off the 7 pin. Picks up another 2, and it's 11 pins now with 7 to play. Scores of 30 as Nardone starts with 3 tens to 24 after 3 in the second half. 4 horses and a sleeper now for Dorian, but he's got wood back behind the 3-pin, or behind the 2-pin there. 4 horses and a post. That's gone. That should be gone. By all rights, that was gone, but Dorian can't get the 8 to fall. Nardone hits his mark too, but he's facing 2 pins with his 3rd ball as well. Ten for Dorian. And an 8. So we're back. Lead is back down to 9. First ball of the 5th frame coming up on lane 10 from John Dorian. He trails by 9. This is the final match in the King of the Hill. 5 drop off the head pin. 6 drop with the eagle wing plus the 9 pin for Nardone. Wood to help. Tough bid, but here comes on the backslide. Not quite enough to finish that. Here it is. This is gone. Nardone with the first mark in the second string here. Followed up, he had started the match with 3 tens and an 8. And that spare puts him at 48 and a ball for his first half. Dorian with his 9 is at 43. There you see the score. Nardone will be looking at 48 and a ball when he comes back. The lead from the first half was 5, so total difference is 10 pins plus that 7. So a 17 pin difference right now. Dorian is off on the 4 pin, gets 2. Boom! Okay, that one wouldn't go. The 7 pin didn't go that time. He hit it just where he wanted to. And the 2 pin. similar outcome for Dorian, who hit his ball right where he wanted to. So both bowlers open in the sixth. And both bowlers with nine. So lead is 64-52 plus the five is going to give you a 17-pin total difference. We've bowled 16 out of 20 frames. Our leader, Mike Nardone, on lane 10, drops the mini rack. He's got the four horses left. Beautiful, beautiful 1-3 pocket for Dorian. He's kind of looking just at the four pin. Nardone takes it. That one is a 40 percenter for a pro. Second mark of the second string for Nardone. And first one for Dorian. So no damage done there. It's still a 17-pin difference. We've got three to play. Both bowlers in the bonus. Head pin two. The 5-7-8. Interesting. Dorian, left side, drops six. So brings the lead back to 18, but a makeable spare for Dorian. He's got the check mark. Every spare is makeable, I guess, but that one was not. Oh! Dorian, just right of the three pin, will be open in the eighth.
That's all right.
And those, that one pin helps. He's at 77 to Nardone's 89, but overall it's a 17-pin lead with two to play. Nardone really probably needs one more mark to solidify his win. Dorian looking, needs two, needs something to fall here. Not, got a 2-1, parallel pins. Nardone got his object, but it was a little thin. He'll be open in the eighth, in the ninth, sorry. Dorian's running out of frames now. Third ball is good for a 10. Nardone at 99 through 9. And Dorian with that 8 is at 85 through 9. And overall, it's a 19-pin difference. Yep, so we're looking at really a double strike territory. Yeah, we're into double strike territory for Dorian. Nardone, it's his object, but he leaves the bundle hay bale on the left. Dorian finds the spread eagle right down the middle. And that will do it. Spare for Nardone, who had 410 in his first three. Followed that up with a 113 and now is at 109 plus his next ball. Whoa, almost the spread eagle conversion. No wood, one percenter for Dorian, but he will throw his last ball at the two pin. And he'll take a 10 for a 95 and a 203 for the day. Our king from July will hand his crown to Nardone, but Mike still has one ball left. Another head pin, another nine, and a shaker, another nine drop. I believe, was that a 118? 118 for a 231. And remember, in his run up through, he was our number four seed, came up with rounds of 138, 148, 124 for a 410 triple. A 641 for five strings, as what our tournament director says. But there you see our new king of the hill. Handicap champion is Mike Nardone with a 231-203 victory over John Dorian. Congratulations to both competitors. And we'll see you next month in September. Fourth Sunday should be the ladder. And in a few hours, we're going to see the handicap, the scratch. Thank you, Justin. Thank you to our competitors. I'm Bob Lee, and I will see you on the lanes. Goodbye from Whitensville.